Welcome back, this is MDog. We are trying out 7664 at Volkov with Redworm Large One hooks. This is where we are on the map, by the way, D7. I'm not sure if I've ever fished here before. I just can't remember. It's been a long time if I have. And we've got Large One hooks, Redworm. I'm not sure about the fluorocarbon leader size. This could be, depends on what we end up catching, right? Could be a little small, we could get in trouble. Might be perfect, we'll see. But let's see what we're catching here. We should see some Vimba along with other random stuff. Ooh, that's a healthy Vimba for the first fish, right? Currently 4 in the morning, just threw our rods in. So let's see what shows up. You know, we probably want to put them all on 7-gram quiver tips. Let's see. It's probably a little bit too much of a run to do that. I kind of wanted to check out the cafe orders, but we'll wait till we at least get through some of this, the morning hours where the fishing should be especially decent here. So based on what I've seen from VK, we should have a chance of some nice Vimba. Possibly regular bream, but hopefully they won't, I mean, you know, hopefully not too much. Because they'll probably be small here. And then who knows what else. We're using redworms, so redworms you can really catch a lot of different species. But, again, this seems to be a pretty decent Vimba spot, at least from what is being reported. We got nibbles on both rods here. Yeah, we're not catching tiny fish. I might just go to 14 gram, 21, something like that. 7 might be too light. Well, that wasn't a nibble. That was just a straight up bite. So let's see what this is. Because it didn't nibble like the Vimba did. Just a regular bream. 15 meter clip. Did I already say that? We are not using ground bait. You certainly could. I don't know that I've ever made a specific ground bait for Vimba. Guess I have. Kind of like this Vimba Nace stuff. Maybe we'll throw that on there. I don't know. We'll see what it looks like first. Just get a couple fish in here the regular way. This third line has had a nibble forever, so see what this is going to be. Might finally be on there. Maybe not. I think line 2 has a fish on again, or at least a nibble. This is one of those crazy nibbles. I hope that fish actually gets on though eventually. Might have stopped. No, it's still there. There it goes. All right, what is this fish gonna be? It was playing with it forever. It's a chub. Okay. Got a little chub there. All right, we'll try the ground bait. Ooh, that's a heavy bite. It's not a big fish though, but man, it pulled it like crazy, didn't it? Oh, that's why it looked like that, because it's a mussel. All right, we'll take some mussel bait. Excuse me. Some white-eye bream is a nice one too. Okay, it's kind of interesting. There's a bimbo, right? Ooh, nice one. Well, we just went weekly record Vimba and weekly record White Eye. Wow. If it's not a bream, could be a nice fish. That's an eyed. Okay. You know what? Oh my goodness. Is this an eyed? We must have timed that like just perfect. I'm gonna switch this one to loop rig. We'll keep it on no ground bait on this one, but I'm gonna go loop rig. Yeah, we've already had some pretty decent bimbas. I could see this spot being pretty slow when it's not morning, though, or evening. I don't know how long we'll sit here. We'll see. We'll see how if it slows down greatly. This is the one without the ground bait. Another nice wide eye. I mean, frankly, we've done really well on the rod without the ground bait, for what that's worth. Really well. Once again, no ground bait. Nice Fimba. Tearing it up here. May go ahead and take off ground bait from another rod. Oh wait, that looks weird, like it's moved pretty far. Right? I'm gonna recast it. I'm gonna take ground bait off this one. We'll just leave it on the third one. This is the one with ground bait. It's an eyed again, isn't it? Some shenanigans going on. All right, so how have we done so far? The Vimbas have been pretty strong. The bite rate's just a little slow, right? But a high percentage of fish that we are catching are really good fish. Whoa! That's the one thing on this first line. I need to change the quiver tip. Maybe it won't do that weirdness too often. All right, after the next fish we catch, we're going to run back to the cafe, see if we've finished any orders. Do we have a fish on? Surely we do. All right, the one with ground bait. I don't know what we want this to be. It's tiny. Oh, is that a blue? No, a white eye. All right, let's go check it out. At least see if we finished any or what we need to finish some. Because of the fast travel, this location actually isn't that far from home base. It's a little bit of a hike, but it's not too bad. Here we are. Oh, we've got two blue bream quests. I do think blue breams are possible there, but they're not super common. And aren't we close on that? 949. Oh, we also could get the river mussel if we don't turn them into bait. 949 on the Vimba. Oh yeah, we had 907. Okay. So it's possible. Couple of possible possibilities there. Yeah, if you don't mind that I'm in just kind of chilling here, I'll keep fishing a little longer. Maybe get to the evening at least. See how this spot shapes up. Let's see if there's any fish on. Yep, line one. Line one. We need to change the quiver tip. See what we got here. Kind of settled on 21 grams. Again, 5.4 fluorocarbon. So far, that's been plenty. I guess you could hit a really, like, decently sized eider or bream. I think you'd be able to get them in, although it could be a little shaky. This is what we don't want to see too much of, is the regular bream. Although at night, those regular bream at least have a chance being markers, probably. Took off, so could this be our muscle? Nope. I'm surprised how many wide eyes we've gotten. Decent amount here. Small. Yeah, that's my fault. It's a chance it could still be on there, but I probably screwed it up. And it seemed like a good fish. Something's still happening with the line, though. We'll see. Screwed it up. All right, it's getting to that time of day where we could potentially have some better fish showing up again. So I feel like that was a very slow middle of the day. We had a few bites, caught a couple fish. I messed up one, but overall pretty slow, right? Oh, this has got to be a mussel, right? Maybe not? Nope. I guess it's a white eye again. They are really here, aren't they? Okay, potential. That's an eyed again. I don't mind catching eyed, but it's not what we're really after. So it doesn't really feel like a farm, does it? Feels like if you're just going for a Vimba trophy, this is your spot, potentially. But for a farm, probably not. There's just too many slow pockets during the day. It seems so good first thing in the morning, but like a lot of spots, to stay decent during the day is asking a lot. Kind of looking at how spread out the bites were. It's gotten crazy slow here at the end of the day. I feel like the amount of like slow nibbles we've had in this spot . Okay. There's a fish on the game, just doesn't realize it yet. It actually looks like it's... We might not catch this one. That looks like that was a mussel. Like, there's no way it would have gone to there without it being a mussel. It's gone, though. That was 100% a mussel, though. Okay, I wonder if that's... Yeah, it's probably an eyed, right? I saw it kind of hit it, but then it seemed like it went away. No, it is a Vimba. It's a nice Vimba. Alright, we're going to go just a little bit longer just to see what the beginning of the overnight portion is like. And then we'll wrap it up, because this has been a long video and really not that many fish caught. Again, not a farm, but if you're looking for a Vimba trophy, this might be the spot for you. Pretty consistently catching Vimba, as far as Vimba go. I mean, Vimba, you know, typically do come in waves. It's not like you ever catch Vimba just one after another, but pretty high percentage of Vimba here. All right, so... Yeah, it might be worth having bark beetle on one line. That might have been an interesting thing to try. Should have looked at that earlier just to see what that does to bite rate. Like, if there's enough other fish that would go on bark beetle, that it'd be worth throwing it in. I think the other thing to check is blue bream. It's always good to see in a spot like this where it feels like blue bream could be possible. You know, do you ever throw out one algae? You also want to go down a little bit in hook size for blue bream. One is crazy, right? So blue bream, we could probably go with like even like a 10 or a 12 and feel much better about things. Whoa. This feels like a regular bream, maybe. Unless it's another eyed. It's a hefty fish. Oh, it is an eyed. Should have known. The eyes have it. Wow. That pull, though. I think it's actually still on there. It's swimming everywhere. It's probably an eyed as well. The way it's swimming. Really? Definitely not a Vimba. Not a bream either. It's got to be an eyed, right? Hmm. This actually might be like a 2.5-3 kilo eyed. I don't know. Yeah, 2.5. All of a sudden, we're catching a few more fish. So, ooh, more bait. I like that. Don't mind that at all. That's a bonus. All right, now we're into the real overnight hours, so let's just give it another couple minutes here to see if we get another bite. It's kind of seeing like just how slow overnight might be. And then I'll update you if this next morning if we happen to hit a trophy. All right. Yeah, so it seems pretty slow at night too. All right, let's run back to base just so I can show you the silver amount. It's not going to be very much, but it's worth just seeing so we can put a bow on it. And yeah, then like I said, I'll update you if we get a trophy the next morning. I'll probably keep fishing this spot a little longer, but we've already made this video 1 hour and we just aren't catching enough fish to sustain going on and on and on. But it's an interesting spot. Again, if you don't have that Vimba trophy, it's worth your time here for sure. Could try the bark beetle larva. All right, so 97 silver. Again, not a silver farm. But I think it would be worth doing some experimenting. Now we have a crayfish order. That's funny. Okay, I think it'd be worth doing some experimenting. You've got three baits at least that might be worth trying. Bark beetle larva, algae, as well as red worm, which we've been using. I would also like to go down in hook size a little bit. One large one feels like we're just trying to sit on that Vimba trophy, which is unnecessary. So 10s, 12s, especially with the bark beetle larva and algae, I think it would be worth your while. I don't think we have a fish on, but let's make sure. No fish, but we do have some floating light. We do have a floating light. Hey, thanks for watching. Sorry, I know I'm low energy tonight. I'm tired, but I wanted to get at least one RF4 video done. I want to check out the new update in the development of Ultimate Fishing 2. I think they released a small patch today. I'm just trying to kind of keep an eye on as updates happen. Yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace out.